Welcome back to the 700 Club. One in three women will get cancer in her lifetime, and one in two men. But despite the odds, Russell Pyle was in shock when he was diagnosed.
2 years ago, Russell Pyle received a death sentence. He was diagnosed with an aggressive form of bladder cancer. Russell and his wife, Marion, braced themselves for the journey ahead. Though Russell agreed to the use of mainstream medical treatments, he also opted for newer, natural remedies. In her book, Healed, Healthy, and Whole, Marion shares the spiritual and nutritional strategies they discovered in their battle against cancer and how they never gave up hope for a miracle.
And Russell and Marion are with us now. Russell and Marion, welcome to the show.
Thank you very much for having us.
Yes. Well, Russell, let's get right to it. You were the picture of health. You're working out all the time, eating right. And suddenly, something went very wrong. When did you first know something was wrong with your health?
I had blood in my urine. And the first symptoms I didn't think too much of, and then it continued. And so my GP said, you better go to a urologist and see what's going on.
Yeah, so you weren't that worried at first, but you said, let's go to the doctor. And what happened, Marion?
Well, something that nobody ever wants to hear. We heard that he had bladder cancer, and we couldn't even imagine it. The word bladder and the word cancer in Russell just didn't even fit in the same sentence. So it actually was a shock to us, and as that kind of news always is, and it turned our world upside down in an instant.
So what was the first thing you did? You went conventional, right? Conventional medicine, which is chemo.
Yeah, well, no chemo. Chemo wouldn't have any effect on this cancer. So they did surgery, took out the tumor, and then I went back in for a couple other surgeries, essentially, which were biopsies, but they were under full anesthesia. And that was the approach. Then this same doctor gave me BCG, which is Bacillus Calmette-Guérin, which is a tuberculosis bacteria that they put in the bladder that inflames the bladder and helps fight the cancer. So those were from the conventional doctor.
Well, the two of you decided, you know, we're going to fight this a little differently. You took a three-way approach to battling this cancer. First one was spiritual, then nutritional, and then alternative. We're going to talk about all those. What did you do spiritually?
Well, as whatever always happens when you're in a crisis, you turn to God and you fall on your face before Him and say, Lord, what are you doing here and what do you want us to do here? So we literally were up at 2 a.m. praying until dawn if necessary. We just started to ask God what He wanted to do with this. We pored over Scripture, Wendy, and we found those promises that jumped off the page at us and right into our hearts, and we knew those were the promises God was giving us. Mm. And we stood on those and we believed them. No matter what it looked like in our circumstances, we said, this is the Word of God, this is the truth. And He promised us to heal us, and we believed Him. So we memorized those and prayed them back to Him. We did this alone, we did this together, and then we mobilized prayer groups where we had up to 100 people around the world praying for Russell. And we gave them the scriptures, we gave them what we felt God was telling us to pray for. So people were focused in prayer. It wasn't just this, let's all pray whatever we feel. We were all very focused.
I like
and
that.
And we also did spiritual inventory because cancer is complicated and it can also be brought on not just from physical ailments and a breakdown in the immune system, but also because of trauma or pain or unresolved issues emotionally or spiritually.
Yeah, interesting.
So we did our own spiritual inventory and worked with a counselor and worked through some issues to just get unblocked and make sure nothing was going to impede the healing.
Right. Okay. Russell, what did you do nutritionally? This is key.
Yes, it was. And we feel it's probably one of the most important besides seeking God's guidance in it. And we sought His guidance even as to what to do. We started with an antifungal diet, which fungus is a precursor to cancer, they believe. And everything that feeds fungus also feeds cancer. So we went on a high antifungal diet.
I mean, no sugar at all.
Well, that would be, no sugar. No anything that would create a fast sugar. No white rice. No even brown rice at the beginning.
And that was interesting. So no wheat, no white rice because of the way it's stored. It can cause the fungal.
Grains are stored in the United States in a way that they have mycotoxins. They get mold on them. So if you consume that, you are ingesting fungus into your body, which is just terrible. It's a precursor to all kinds of disease, not just cancer, but it can be other kinds of disease too.
Okay.
And then we went to an 80-20 diet along with that, which was 20% animal protein and 80% plant. Some people would recommend on severe cases that we didn't feel we were quite there. 100% vegan, no animal protein.
Yeah, I've heard that with fighting cancer. But so you said, now when you say protein, are you talking about red meat, fish, and chicken?
Or I'm talking about any animal protein.
Okay.
Because they're acidic. And they produce, and we want to get the body into a neutral acid alkaline balance. And cancer hates alkaline, but loves acid.
Oh.
So you want to keep, if you have to go full vegan to get rid of the acid condition, then
that's very interesting. Because I know a lot of people battle with too much acid in their system and trying to get. Okay, so you're battling it spiritually, you've got the prayer going, you're battling it nutritionally, and then you're battling it also with alternative therapies.
Yes.
What kind?
We did about 8 different kinds of therapies, which are detailed in the book, but I'll tell you about 2 of them, which are interesting. One was the hyperbaric chamber, which was used for divers to help from bends originally. And they put you in this glass tube and they fill it full of oxygen and take you down to atmospheres. And you lay there for 90 minutes with this oxygen. Well, cancer hates oxygen. Healthy cells love oxygen. In fact, they heal under oxygen.
I had never heard that before. That is so interesting. And it's in your book that cancer hates oxygen.
That's right.
So you're taking the oxygen.
Then then vitamin C therapy. I sat with a drip with two liters of, or 2 bags.
Like I'm not sure.
Vitamin C in solution intravenously while I sat and read a book. And the combination of the oxygen and the vitamin C produce hydrogen peroxide, which is lethal to cancer.
Okay, guys, tell me what happened 10 months later. Just 10 months after you're doing all these things, what was the diagnosis, Russell?
You are cancer-free. In fact, the nurse said when we called, oh, I have to go get your records, which was over after Christmas and we were dying to know. And she said, it was negative. And I said, well, what does negative mean?
I know, right? That doesn't sound good.
Yeah.
And she said, no, you're cancer-free.
Yeah. Well, praise the Lord.
Praise
and we've
God.
Been cancer-free for a year and a half.
Well, you guys have an awesome book out called Healed, Healthy, and Whole. It has a lot more. And I love the way it almost reads like a devotional. You're going to love this. It's available wherever books are sold. Marion, Russell, great having you on the show. Thanks
so much
for your testimony.
Oh, thank you. What a pleasure.
Appreciate it.